So one of the major causes of dry eye syndrome and dry eye symptoms has to do with the thickening and blockage of oil glands within the eyelids, which we call Meibomian Gland Dysfunction, or MGD for short. This is where the normally smooth and liquid oils within the meibomian glands stop producing properly and instead form a waxy, harder substance which can go rancid, leading to inflammation of the eyelid and increased tear film evaporation. And this has been found to affect over 80% of everybody with dry eye syndrome, which is exactly why meibomian gland dysfunction treatment is such a major focus for so many dry eye specialists. But what are the most current and effective treatments for MGD? Whether you are looking for advanced treatments through your eye care provider or looking for at-home therapies, that's what we're covering today. So let's take a look. This video is brought to you by the makers of Tear Restore, the dry eye warm compress uniquely designed to permit the use of your Azasite throughout the eyelid treatment, which makes it easy for me to complete my morning warm compress routine while staying productive. Thank you to Tear Restore for helping us keep making dry eye education possible. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. If you are new here to the channel and you suffer from dry eyes, then consider hitting the subscribe button down below so that you don't miss any of our future content on dry eye syndrome. Also, this video is part of a full dry eye series where we go over different types of dry eye syndrome so you can figure out what you have, as well as the different treatment options available, whether it be something done at home or if it's through your eye care provider. If you want to check out videos in that full series, I'll put that link in the description below so you can find it easily. Now, when it comes to treatment for meibomian gland dysfunction, the first one that I like to discuss is that of doing eyelid warm compresses. Now, on this channel, we've talked about eyelid warm compresses many times before, but I think it deserves mentioning again because so many of our patients, as an eye doctor, a lot of people will tell them to do this and then they just fail to really do it or incorporate it into their normal daily routine. Unfortunately, with meibomian gland dysfunction, this is typically a chronic condition and is something that you need to keep doing and managing over time. But the whole point of doing an eyelid warm compress is to supply heat to the meibomian glands. Any solidified, now waxy oils can then be melted down into a liquid, and then that liquid can hopefully be expressed from these oil glands, and then your eyelid is able to reduce the inflammatory load because it doesn't have that rancid oil still stuck in the glands, and that'll hopefully allow your body to make new oils so that your tears don't evaporate as quickly. It also acts as a protective function because if the oils have remained wax in those glands for too long, the gland can eventually atrophy and die off. And unfortunately, if that happens, there really isn't any way that we know at the timing of this video to get them to grow back. Now, there are many different types of warm compresses on the market that you can choose from. There are ones that you activate through a sodium acetate chemical reaction, such as the Tear Restore. There's ones that you put in the microwave, and there's ones that you plug in into a computer or through a USB into a wall socket, and then electronically heat up the oil glands. With whichever method that you choose or that your doctor recommends, the important thing is that you do them on a regular basis at least once or twice a day for at least 10 to 20 minutes at a time. Clinical studies and from clinical experience, that is the appropriate amount to be using to get a clinical benefit where we start to see improved function of the oil glands. After completing warm compresses, many eye doctors will recommend doing some form of eyelid massage. When I was just in school, maybe 5-6 years ago, then at that time, my professors would just recommend doing a little gentle digital massage with your finger. The downside of doing that is if you push too hard, you could be putting unnecessary pressure on the globe of the eye, and that could increase risk for things like glaucoma if you're someone who's at risk for it. That is why now there's a lot of new devices that are coming out, including one that I featured previously on this channel called the Newlids device, which creates kind of a mechanical activating motion that agitates the oil glands and allows them to encourage that oil gland, those oils to open up and release. There's also other devices and warm compresses coming out that use vibration to try and achieve the same effect. Now, if you're somebody with a more severe form of meibomian gland dysfunction, the oil glands can become capped off in the form of eyelid scaling. This is where the eyelids themselves start to have the appearance of chapped lips in the winter, where there's dead epithelial skin cells that are now covering the oil glands and prevent the glands from even releasing their contents. In that situation, your doctor may recommend doing an eyelid debridement with a small tool in the clinic, and then they could even recommend doing meibomian gland probing, where a small, almost needle-like tool is used to puncture the oil glands to allow them to open up. Then your doctor may even do manual meibomian gland expression. This is using a small forceps in the clinic to pinch the individual glands to really express all of its contents. I do encourage you, do not attempt to do this at home. It is something that must be done by an eye care professional. Now let's shift over and talk about some advanced technologies for meibomian gland dysfunction treatment that may be available for you at your local eye care provider or eye clinic. The first one I like to talk about, is probably because it's been out the longest, is that of LipiFlow. Now, LipiFlow is a mechanical device that either your eye doctor or a technician can apply to your eyelids, and then what it does is apply heat to both sides of the eyelid. So it's not just like doing a warm compress where you're trying to get heat through the skin. It applies heat to both sides of the eyelid at the same time. And then it has a pumping action that encourages those glands to continually express any of those oils out of the glands. And since LipiFlow has been out for quite some time, there are a lot of studies that do show good clinical support for benefits of getting the LipiFlow done. It even shows some clinical benefit lasting up to 3 years after a single treatment. However, I do also want to mention that a lot of people will have severe forms of meibomian gland dysfunction and may need multiple treatments with something like LipiFlow to have really the desired effect. Now, very similar to the LipiFlow is a device called the Eyelux. The Eyelux, again, applies heat to the eyelids, but it does this through supplying infrared and a lime light to this top surface of the eyelid. But it makes sure that it applies heat throughout the entire lid because it also has a sensor reading that goes underneath the eyelid so it can tell that it's fully heated up the lids. But then the device also has a mechanical pumping action, which again helps express the oils from the eyelid. Now, as far as the difference between LipiFlow and Eyelux, the LipiFlow is something where your doctor can set it up and then they can just hit the start button and it'll run on its own. Eyelux is something that has to be done mechanically and manually, so your eye doctor or your doctor's assistant will have to perform the procedure on your eyelid. And as far as the ultimate clinical result between those two, at least one study has shown them to be equally equivalent at treating meibomian gland dysfunction. One additional technology I want to mention is that of tear care. Some eye clinics will offer tear care as a way to add additional heat to those eyelids within the clinic, but this device does not have the mechanical pumping action, so instead your doctor may offer a meibomian gland expression done in the clinic, again using some sort of mechanical forceps. Now, just to speak on my personal experience, I've had both the LipiFlow and the Eyelux done. I find them to be very comfortable and have good results. As far as having something like tear care or manual expression, I've never really had that done, but I've done it for patients and they seem to respond well to it as well. The one other cool technology that many eye clinics are now starting to offer is something that is technically not FDA approved for the treatment of dry eye or meibomian gland dysfunction at this current time. I say that because I believe they are applying for FDA approval at this current moment, and it's something that we'll talk about in a future video, hopefully when that comes out. Otherwise, this is something called IPL, intense pulsed light. This originally was developed for dermatologists to treat things like ocular rosacea and just rosacea of the skin in general. But they have since found that it has this kind of this side effect extra benefit of reducing the inflammatory load on the eyelids and heating up these oil glands and helping remove telangiectasia, which is the growth of abnormal blood vessels on the eyelids too. Now, the treatment with IPL is a little bit more involved. They do have to have a handheld device put onto the lids, and it requires several treatments, at least usually 4 treatments, to have a benefit. But I would not be surprised if you go to see a dry eye specialist in your area and they discuss with you the advantages of something such as the IPL treatment. But be sure to stay tuned to the channel because hopefully we'll have some cool videos coming out soon on the IPL. So now that we've discussed some new technologies in the eye clinics that are available for helping meibomian gland dysfunction, now let's move over and talk about some of the different eye drops, medications that are available, as well as oral medications or supplements that your eye doctor could recommend for you. Now, two medications that are available in the form of an eye drop for treating meibomian gland dysfunction, one of those is something called Cyclosporin A. That's the generic name. Otherwise, their brand names such as Restasis or a new form called Cequa are available. These are eye drops used twice a day and have long since been used mainly for different forms of dry eye disease. But there are studies that do show that there is some clinical benefit for meibomian gland dysfunction through using these eye drops. Some of the biggest downsides for using a medication such as Restasis or Cequa is oftentimes the cost. The prices for these medications can get quite costly, and they often take several months to start seeing a clinical benefit. However, with that being said, I have many patients who are on or using these medications, and they have excellent responses. So again, something to talk with your eye care provider about. Another topical eye drop that can be used to help with meibomian gland dysfunction is that of topical Azasite. Now, topical Azasite is often used as an antibiotic, usually prescribed for just a 7-day course. However, eye doctors have been shown in studies that if you're using it for a longer treatment period, that it can have benefits for the meibomian glands in the eyelid. However, oftentimes, just like topical cyclosporin, these medications can sometimes be rather expensive. So it's important to again talk with your eye care provider and work with your insurance to see what's going to be best for you. Now, it's very similar functioning to Azasite in that this medication helps reduce inflammation in these oil glands. There's also the use of taking oral doxycycline. Now, oral doxycycline is again an antibiotic that's often prescribed for many different forms of infection. However, usually at a lower clinical dose that doesn't necessarily have the same side effects as a full antibiotic dose of doxycycline, has also been shown to change the function of these oil glands in your skin and consequently can help improve things like rosacea as well as these oil gland functionings of the meibomian glands. But in comparison to the topical Azasite, doxycycline has been out for a long time, and so usually it's much more affordable. The biggest downsides is that oral doxycycline may have more side effects than using something like the topical Azasite. Now, another possible treatment for meibomian gland dysfunction is that of taking supplements for omega-3s. Now, omega-3 fatty acids has been an interest of study in medicine in many different subjects of medicine, whether it be cardiology, neurology, dermatology, and then, of course, eye care for quite some time. And in the dry eye space, there is a lot of conflicting evidence. Now, while there is some debate of omega-3 for its benefits for dry eye and even meibomian gland dysfunction, I'm mentioning it here because I think it is something that some doctors will recommend for you, but I think it's really important that before taking any supplement, whether it be something like flaxseed oil or fish oil, anything like that, best talk to your eye care provider so that they can go over your medications and health history to make sure it is something best for you or if it's something that they even recommend. But either way, eating a diet that has more omega-3s and less omega-6s is healthy for the body and recommended no matter what, dry eye or not. So now, where are you at with meibomian gland dysfunction? Do you have a really severe case? Have you had any of these treatments mentioned, such as a Lipoflow, iLux, maybe IPL treatments? Have you been taking omega-3 supplements? Have you been put on medications like Restasis? Are you doing warm compresses every single day? Let us know in the comments what you have tried, what has helped for you, and overall, kind of where you're at with your whole dry eye experience. Or if you need help finding a dry eye specialist in your area, again, drop comments in the section below. I'll include extra links in the video description to help you find a dry eye specialist. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. If this video helped you out, hit the like button for us, share this with friends and family, anyone you know that is struggling with dry eye syndrome. Either way, thanks so much for watching. Again, this is Dr. Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.